Hello everyone, this is Hammertron here with a new review video for you. This time I am reviewing the Safari Limited Earth Dragon. This is set number 100067. This was first molded in 2019 and I bought this in late 2021 in a store. When I bought it, it had a tag wrapped around his neck with this piece of plastic here. It came with a warning card in English and some other languages. And here is the tag. It has some basic information inside and some manufacturing information on the back there. So let's take a look at the dimensions of this Dragon figurine. So at the widest point, I think from wing tip to wing tip, looks like it is maybe 6.5 inches or almost 7 inches wide. And the length, looks like the length is at the longest point. Looks like it is about 5 inches long, or a little bit more than 5 inches long. And at the highest point, I think up to this wing tip there. Looks like it is a little more than 7 inches tall. Such a nicely sized dragon figurine. So this is the Earth Dragon. I think it's good for the day that this video is posted. It'll be the first official day of spring for the year 2022. So as an Earth Dragon, it certainly looks like a dragon. And one noticeable feature is the wings. The wings are rubbery and flexible. We don't want to bend these too much because they'll eventually break. But on the inside, looks like it's blue, painted blue or dark blue. And it has some stars in here, some gold stars. And it looks like these stars are sculpted into the mold for the wings. So these are not stickers. Looks like they are part of the wing mold. Now the wings are nice, not perfectly smooth, so I think they're meant to be similar to leaves. The other side of the wings, kind of green, no stars. Now I like the head. The head of the dragon is very nice. Now it does not have reptilian eyes. And if we look at the horns, I think the horns are meant to be branches and they have some leaves on them. And then a few leaves sculpted here, tree branches and leaves. So it makes me wonder if the scales are meant to be leaves instead of actually reptilian scales. Although it's a little hard to tell. I think the scales can go either way on this particular dragon figurine. It's a lot of nice detailed work there. And then there's spikes on the back. They seem to be a little bit curled, so I'm not sure if these are meant to be some kind of leaf or some kind of plant life. So rather nice spikes, mostly along the spine here. Not many spikes on the back of the neck there. And then these spikes seem to disappear on the tail. It's rather hard plastic, so this part is not flexible, so that's good. The arms and the legs are not flexible. I can't bend them, I'm not going to try very hard. Some nice scale work here on the front of the neck here and on the chest and on the belly. This is where some manufacturing information is. That's where it says it's made in China. It's the Earth Dragon 2019. Some nice scale work here on the bottom or underside of the tail. So this dragon is mostly green, I think meant to represent green plant life for springtime in the leaves. But if we look at the arms here and the legs, it doesn't look like it has any scale work or leaves meant to be like scales. It looks more like vines or plant life. Now what's really interesting is if we look at the hands and the feet here, they're painted brown, or maybe the whole thing is molded in a brown plastic, or is it green plastic? I'm not sure. But it looks like these hands and these feet here are meant to be tree trunks. So this is definitely a very plant-based dragon. If we look at the underside of the feet or the paws, there's not a whole lot of detail there. It's pretty smooth, which is fine, considering we usually keep the figurine standing up. We're not going to see the bottoms of the feet or paws very often, so it doesn't have to be very detailed there. But I do like the creativity of this dragon figurine. Just seems to be very plant-like. You know, part of the forest. So it's a nice dragon to celebrate the coming of spring for the year. I think it's a very impressive figurine, perhaps one of my favorite dragon figurines so far, because of how they managed to bring in some tree or plant life and incorporated that into the dragon's body. So this is the Safari Limited Earth Dragon. Thank you for watching my video. Please like the video, leave a comment, and subscribe to my channel to keep up to date with my future reviews. Until next time, goodbye everyone.